Oh my god, I can actually run again. I'm free! I'm finally free! Today is a glorious day. Hello, birds. I feel as free as you do. Okay, let me explain what happened. So I loaded up one of my save games from when I was in that lab with a green dude trying to ruin my day and trapping me in a corner. And I ran out and I went looking for somebody who could improve my equipment, because I was hoping that Lost Alpha has the upgrade for the exoskeleton that allows you to sprint, because I know that existed in, I believe it was Misery, and I think even Call of Pripyat, too, had it. Although I'm not sure. Anyway, I was hoping that that upgrade would exist. So I went looking for that, and thanks to a tip from a viewer, it turns out you don't actually have to go all the way back to Petrenko, so thankfully I did not have to spend a half hour going all the way back to Petrenko, who is... where even is he? Here. All the way here. Oh my god, it would take so fucking long to get there, but thankfully I didn't have to. It turns out, thanks to his tip, there's actually somebody who can do the same thing as Petrenko, right here. This is actually the Freedom Base. And there's somebody there who can repair your stuff, and who also has unlimited money. So thankfully, it was actually a very quick little jaunt over there. Unfortunately, the upgrade to make you able to sprint with the exoskeleton suit does not exist. So I thought, fuck, what do I do now? I was thinking I'm probably gonna have to sell my exoskeleton suit and buy something else. Thankfully, though, that's not the case. It turns out, you can actually just mod it to allow you to sprint. So that's exactly what I did. I actually extracted one of the game archive files, opened up the outfit file, and you can edit the properties of, well, any item you want to. So I actually just simply changed one little line from something like allow sprint false to allow sprint true. And just like that, I can finally sprint. Yeah, it's kind of a hack or cheat or whatever, but honestly, I do not give a shit. If the fact that I couldn't run was some sort of an interesting gameplay mechanic that actually led to interesting situations, that would be another case. But it doesn't. Not being able to sprint is not interesting. It doesn't lead to anything interesting. The only thing it leads to is incredible monotony and frustration and annoyance. It's terrible. It just ruins the game. So I feel no shame in editing it. Perfectly fine with it. It's already annoying enough to travel around, my god. Doesn't need to be any more annoying. So here I am, I've returned back to the laboratory and now I can finally sprint. And, oh by the way, when I was looking for the upgrade to be able to sprint, the one that didn't exist, even though it didn't exist, there were some other upgrades. Two of them, actually. So one thing I did is upgrade the night vision to be the better kind. And I also got a slight boost to my radiation protection. Let's see... radiation 45%. I can't remember what it was, I think it was like a 15% boost or something. I think it was 15%. So, yeah. Here we go. Hopefully this will be a little bit more tolerable down here. Hi. Okay, you do have to get out of my way though, thank you. Okay. Thank God. Can leave him in the dust back there, see ya! If you get really far away from him, he starts to sprint after you as he's doing right now, but I can still outrun him. Okay. So I'm supposed to escape the security system and do stuff. Disable generator. Yeah. And this place seems to go on forever. Oh yeah, when I was at the Freedom Base, I also bought some more ammo, by the way. In fact, I actually spent all of my money on ammo. Mostly armor piercing, because that's what I needed the most, so now I'm basically poor. I have 452 rue. Where's the... there's a door that goes to another place. Is this it? Yeah, here we go. Nah, I don't need the night vision. Okay. Yeah, try going up there. That goes to a door that can't be opened. That's where all the doggies spawned. I don't think there's anything in here. Wait, did I go this way? I think I did. I'm pretty sure I did. I was looking for buttons. Something. Out of my way, please. Thank you. Why am I hearing chimes? Ah, the zone. If anything strange happens, that can always be the explanation. Ah, it's the zone. Why am I growing a beard on my knee? It's the zone. Right, two ways to go. Have I gone this way? No, I've definitely not. Excuse me. I've definitely not gone this way. And I don't know if I want to. Yeah, fuck it. Ooh, soul. I can't believe I didn't get hurt there. There's gotta be something good back here, right? Please? Please? Doesn't look good. There's nothing. Shit, I'm gonna get trapped back here. No! Is there really nothing back there? Come on. You're phasing through boxes, motherfucker. Nothing back here? Shit. I think he's forgotten about me. Oh no, he remembered me! Yeah, okay. For some reason, he can go through boxes, but I can't walk through him. What a load of crap. Yeah, I'm pretty sure there's no map markers for any of this stuff, even disabled generator. Like, am I supposed to do something with him? Get through security system. That just means get away from him, right? To some place, a destination? So the only reason to come back here was just for that artifact, I guess? I don't know, seems weird. Isn't this just where I went and I got trapped? Like, this doesn't open, right? Can't get up the fucking stairs. I don't even know if he's coming. I think this is the way I came from. Anyway, it looks like he's trapped. I'm looking at his icon on the— Oh! He teleported! Okay, fine. Thanks. Wonderful. Okay, this looks new. Actually, blue? I don't remember blue. Oh! Hello, this is good. It seems promising. Of course. Fuck it up. Oh, thanks. Oh my god! Okay, other side of the thing. Cool. This is promising. Did I just go in a circle? Huh. Ooh. Okay! Thank fucking god I think I found something! And I can sprint! Oh, the fucker's still coming. Hold on. I need to play some Tetris. Damn it, it doesn't work! Ah! Ooh, bubbles! Disable it. That didn't work. I guess I have to go in there. Stop pointing at me. Hi. To turn the earthquake machine off, press F. F you! Okay. Sweet. All done. Brain scorcher's off. Doomsday device is off. Wow, I just realized that thing's a huge fucking brain. Ew. Anything in here? Old radios? Ooh, can I get up there? Whoa! Jesus! Doesn't even work, does it? It's a faulty ladder. Maybe I just have faulty hands. Okay. Well, let's get the hell out of here. It's pointing me this way, but... there's no doorway over there, is there? Nah, I just gotta go out the way I came in. Could be other cool stuff I missed in here. Special artifacts and whatnot. Oh wow, so actually... where I needed to get was actually very close to where I started, but it was just covered up with this crap here. Blocking the hallway. Okay. Nope. I came from that way. I don't know if it's the best way to go, but that is where I came from. Okay, I think I got it.
Hey, come and get me.
What? The fuck was that? Wait a minute. Lists there as being someone on the map here. Look, it says one. I'm gonna back up. Zero. What? Whatever. Quest just says to speak to Veronin, so... I think you've got a neck problem there, buddy. Alrighty. Cool. Those weren't there before. And we're done. Thank God. If the next mission is to disable yet another device in a lab, I am going to... eat my cake? The artifact that is? And see if it actually tastes like cake? Looks pretty delicious. Kind of looks like a pastry. Maybe the blue stuff is like some sort of a berry filling. Mmm, looks like it would taste like clouds. Oh shit, hi. Hi. Okay. Well, gonna put this suit to some use. Alright, one shot. Armor piercing. Let's put some more armor piercing up here. I guess the monolithians that we're worshipping woke up. This thing is so ridiculously accurate. After the accuracy upgrade I did to it, look at that. It's pretty much maxed. Looks like it could shoot a fly out of the air from a mile away. I was checking to make sure he was actually an enemy. Like, I was pretty sure, but I just want to be sure. Hmm. Someone sprayed this tree with some jam. Wow, that's some terrible shooting on my part. Thank you for the guns. I will store them in stretch and go sell them to the market. Man, I love the extra weight capacity of this suit. Look at this. Can hold up to 70. I've got so many guns and I'm not even full yet. It's a hoarder's dream. Ooh, crystal thorn, hello. It's not actually worth all that much, but... could be used for a recipe or something. I don't think their pathfinding is good enough to actually get to me. Alright, rolling in style. Looking sexy in this suit. Like a bionic man. It is quite a relief to have somewhere nearby where I can actually sell my stuff. I should maybe do that now, actually. Yeah, I mean, it's on my way back anyway, and I'm extremely poor at the moment. So let's go do it. Gotta take a left. Up here. See if I can stock up on some more ammo. Good on AP, but I could use some more standard rounds. Oh, shit. Yeah, squeezing through here is a little bit awkward. Visit to the Freedom People. They apparently have a quest line, too. I speak to their leader. Don't know where he is, though. I'm not sure how much I care. Because unless, honestly, the quests just don't really seem to give me much of anything if they're not the main quest. Could be different for this, but I don't know. I'm trying to remember where the hell to go. Oh, it's up here. Yeah, okay, I've kind of driven into a shitty spot. Let's see if I can drive my way out of it. Oh yeah, no problem. Think it's here? This doesn't seem right. Hold on. Whoa. Since when can I have my gun out when I'm in the car? I thought I couldn't. Huh. No, this isn't the place, is it? There's a bunch of people in here, but I don't think this is where the guy is to sell stuff. Oh, no, no, no. Yeah, it is. There he is. Alright, well, perfect. Wish this place had a sign or something. It's a little bit nondescript. Alright, let's get selling. Normally I'd cut this out, but given how close the dude is to the car, I might as well just do it all right now. It's really, really dark in here. Hey, Skinflint. My mustachioed, kind of creepily named friend. Oh, wow! You know what, the prices he gives me for this stuff is fucking terrible. That is really, really bad. Maybe if I do quests for freedom and get my faction standing up, they'll give me better prices? I don't know. See if I can find a leader or something. I mean, where the hell would the leader be? I don't know, I don't want to sell myself for that price though, that's pretty terrible. Alright, back up. Alright, where'd the leader be? I want to say he might be above. Yeah, yeah. I think this is him. One of these. Is it you? No? Is it you? Yes, I think. I was passing by and thought I would introduce myself. A wise move. My guys don't like unfamiliar faces walking around here. They get a bit twitchy. So what's your name, Stalker? I'm Strelok. Strelok. Wow. In the flesh. You're a very good person to know, so I hear. Really? Well, if you say so. Ah, come on. Don't be modest, man. I heard you're a man who gets the job done. I'm Lukash, by the way. Leader of freedom in these parts and all other parts. He? That's supposed to be a laugh, right? He? Okay. Well. Now it's kind of ruined, isn't it? Maybe one day you could join us in our quest for freedom. Maybe, but I have many things to do first. Okay. Apparently I can't help him yet. Ow. Right, let's just go back to Vronin. Maybe the quest will initiate as part of the main quest or something. Oh, I'm out of gas. That was fun. Can I just drive across the field? I mean, shit. Why not? Hey, hold on. What's this little building? It's cute. Whoa! Okay. Well, thankfully, Stretch took the brunt of that. There's someone here. A really cool little building. Guide. Strelok, it's nice to see you with such vitality. I believed you had truly passed away, but it seems I was wrong. I am Guide. The very same from the legends, more or less. The one who led you to the center months ago. Do you remember me? Vaguely. That handwriting was familiar, and Doc wanted to get a hold of you too. And now, here I am. Ask anything and I will answer with whatever humble insights I have. Okay, good to know. See ya. That was like the most awkward conversation ever. Oh. Okay, if I talk to him again, then I can ask questions? What? That makes no sense. I wonder if he gives me full price. He doesn't have much money, though. Turn off my lamp. Can't even see his face, but what the hell? Because a wandering dog just got blown up. Why did you lead me to the center of the zone in the first place? It was a hunch. At first, I didn't know who you people were, but something in my gut told me you were to be trusted. A seemingly normal guy such as yourself, among all these warped realities, was an attractive prospect, I must admit. The whole thing kind of reminded me of these two other guys I took once, a professor and a writer. Call it an act of charity, or perhaps I was getting bored that day. You figure it out and choose which suits your ego. See ya. What the hell's with this conversation structure? The fuck? Hi, I'm back. How did you get us past the brain scorcher back then? Call it intuition if you must. I'm no man of science or God by any means, but I can read the zone like an open book. What you might see as boars feasting on a dead stalker, I would see as a clue about the zone around us and an opportunity to learn more. I have a sort of sixth sense that allows me to casually sidestep the inconveniences of the zone. Knowing how to pass the scorcher back then was as natural as the act of walking. Right. See ya! What do you know about the zone's origins? Whatever you've come to suspect is a half-truth. Indeed, the zone was given life by the mistakes of humanity. But it has grown beyond mere human understanding. It has a unripe sentience to it. The embryo of a new realm, not bound by cosmic laws. Even if the zone's core is to be torn to pieces, it won't make it disappear. At best, it'll only stop the growth. Yet somehow, I doubt it would all end there like a fairy tale. This only seems like a prologue or something far more sinister. Prologue to something far more sinister. Interesting theory. By the way, I kind of messed up actually reading it quite a bit. See you! Wait. Whoa! What? What? The fuck just happened? I don't even know anymore. Anyway, what I was gonna say is, it looks like he has a stash of stuff. I should probably check it out. He is quite literally a fucking magician. Yeah, I'll just vacuum all up and store it in my vehicle. This place almost seems like a miniature church. What? What? Why does my vehicle keep exploding? Why am I casually sitting in midair? How come I can't talk to Guide in like a normal humanly fashion? How come Guide disappeared? Okay, well, there are many mysteries to the zone, but looks like Stretch is about to blow up, so let's go ahead and repair. There we go. Right. Yeah. My brain hurts. I think I'm just gonna leave. Okay, all the crap is stored, almost. Now it is, yes. Let's go before it explodes again. Ah. The zone. Right. Speak to Fang. Who is next to Veronin? Yes? No. No, you are... Swamps? That's where you are? It's pretty far away. Let's deal with Veronin first. I do not want to drive this thing through the swamps. It goes like 2 miles per hour. Honestly, I kind of need more fuel, too. I'm not low, but I'm getting there. Wheels got some serious traction. You know, I wonder if the barkeep would actually give me more money than the freedom dudes would. Let's see.
Come up here. Let's have a little chat.
Let's not. Two seconds of music. That's match third-party content right there. Ooh, what is that? It looks different from mine. Yeah, no, it does look different. Oh, is that the lighter version? Wait, they seem to have the same stats. What? Huh? Whatever. Anyway, it doesn't even matter. Nah, it looks like he gives me about the same. Well, regardless, I do want to buy some fuel. I just really, really, really want to make sure I don't run out. Anything else to buy? Grenades, don't really use them. Some more ammo? Never hurts. Can barely get any. Alright, take 30 rounds, whatever. Marked one. We can't thank you enough. A possible conflict with freedom has been avoided in our moment of vulnerability. Vulnerability. There we go. Now we can concentrate on our own work without all the interruptions. NP. As a token of our appreciation, I will inform my equipment repair specialist, and he'll give you a flat rate. Also, someone left a note for you while you were gone. Seems he wants to meet you at the old church. Does he? Task complete. Meet guide. 'Cause I already met him. Okay. Interesting. Right. I'll inform my equipment repair specialist, and he'll give you a flat rate. Who is his equipment repair specialist? Name, please? Right. Thanks. Yeah, who's your repair specialist? Who are you talking about? Petrenko? Does someone here now repair my stuff? I mean, it's certainly not the Freedom guy, right? Since they are a different faction, so surely that is not your equipment repair specialist. Is it you? Okay. I don't, maybe there's some dude in the 14 dudes on my map right now that can repair my equipment, but whatever. If there is, I'd like to know, because, you know, I'm in good standing with them, so I'm sure that they would be happy to give me a good price. Anyway, so that did, yeah, I did complete the quest, so thankfully the quest adapted to the fact that I had already spoken to him. Now, sadly, the only thing left to do is go speak to Fang, who is rather far away. Okay, there should be someone here who can repair my stuff. Like, there really should be. I mean, this is a base. This is an outpost for duty. They should have someone. But no one's mentioned there being anybody here. Which is why I'm thinking maybe there isn't. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway. I'm gonna cut here, and when I come back, I will be speaking to Fang. Could you please stop humping my car? Okay, we have arrived at our destination. Almost. Fang should be about 90 meters up here. Isn't this going to be a fence? Oh, right, he's, yeah, inside of the thing. Which is accessed from here. If I remember right, I have a pile of ammo on the ground. Yeah. It's not usable stuff though, right? It's only for that... What was it for, the sniper rifle? Yeah. Might as well take it, actually. Could sell it. Don't exactly have any weight problems anymore. Hello! Wait, what? Did you always have glasses? Huh. Hi. You sure took your time, Strelok. Just decided to reappear after all these months, did you? Well, whatever happened to you is your own business. Anyhow, it's good to see you again. Oh wait, no, this isn't the guy I met here last time. I met, what was it, Ghost? Yeah, that's a different guy. Okay, that explains why I don't recognize him. You. I seem to remember your face somehow. You're Fang, right? Yep, I'm Fang, all right. I see the amnesia is still present to a degree. Well, your noggin will settle down in due time. But enough with that. We've got serious matters to attend to. Strelok, do you remember what we were planning back a few months ago? I can't remember much. I've been working on assembling a decoder from old technical notes I wrote way back when to open up a lab beneath the generators. Possibly in this lab is the key to turn off what is the main cause of these energy blowouts and all the madness. Yes, it's slowly coming back to me now. So what do we do next? Well, I just found the last part for this decoder device, and I'll take it to Yantar. And then I'll meet you guys in Pripyat. Until then, you should go and meet Ghost, who is already in the Pripyat Hotel, room 26. Then wait for my return, then we will discuss what to do next. Okay, as long as you're the one taking it to Yantar. Thank God. Alright. Hey, I don't suppose you have unlimited money, do you? No, goddammit. Where did you learn all of your mechanical skills? Self-taught. All of it. I guess it helps I know mathematics better than most of the dropouts in this cesspool. As long as you got the will and the time, anything is possible. Newton invented calculus without a stinking computer, right? Well, I created the ecologist's vaunted psi helmets with just pen and paper. Wait, you invented the psi helmet? Yeah, not that long ago. Sold off the blueprints to them since I didn't have the precision tools to do it myself. Asses can't be bothered to at least mention my name when they brag about it. To hell with them. Their payment still sits in a bank account somewhere in the Bahamas. Taxpayer money at work. You know, when we're done with all this madness, we could bail out and live the big life. You, me, Ghost, Doc, hell. If he wants, we'll bring Guide along. Yeah, that'd be sweet. Yeah, sounds great, man. Alright, gotta go. I'm pretty sure Pripyat's pretty damn far away, though. Let's get back to the car and figure it out. Pretty sure it is. Travel to Pripyat via radar. Ooh, I just barely dodged a death trap on the ground. Hold on. Let me get in the car. Oh man, this stuff is really heavy. Yeah, it's probably worth quite a bit. Okay, it's good to go. Oh, I did have an artifact in there, by the way. I didn't show you it, but I was just walking along here, and I believe it was a thorn artifact. Just was rolling on the ground right here. Just picked it up. It's a very cheap artifact. I think it's worth 1,000. Not very good at all. Alright, where am I going? Alright, it wants me to go back here. It's basically just back the way I came. Okay, well, I think I'm actually gonna end this episode here. Yeah. What the fuck? The hell was that? All I did was press F to try to get out of the fucking car. What even just happened? Anyway, things are definitely back on track. The annoyance of the lack of running ability on the freaking exoskeleton is thankfully gone now. And that makes all the difference. And the traveling that I'm having to do, although still a little bit annoying, is not too bad, because at least I'm not having to go across half the damn map. So, much better. Yeah, definitely enjoying it a lot more than I was in the last episode, no doubt about that. Alright, so I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I suppose we'll head over to Pripyat and figure out what's going on over there.